Howdy, folks. I got something here that I don't see very often. And this is a Fender F-25 made in Japan in 1979. And it still actually is in pretty good shape. So I went through common electric guitar problems. So I guess I'll go through common acoustic guitar problems. There is some overlap, obviously the fret wear, and that would be a big overlap. Loose hardware, loose tuners, that sort of thing. But anyway, we'll just go through all the shit that happens to an acoustic guitar. And this one has really lasted. 79, 89, 99, 2000, over 30 years old. And still rocking. Okay, let's start with common acoustic guitar problems. One big deal that'll always happen to every acoustic guitar to a certain extent, I don't care how much you pay for it, the top is going to sink. Over time, string tension is going to pull the bridge up and pull the top down. And that's going to increase your string action here at the 12th fret in a way that we don't like. So what we can do is we're able to, zoom out a little bit here, like that. We're able to shave that bridge saddle down to a point that'll allow the strings to be at the right height. Now, on an acoustic guitar, what we'd like to see, most factories set the 12th fret at 7/64 on the bass side, 5/64 on the treble side. I like to go 1/64 less than that, so that's 6/64 or 3/32 on the bass side. 4/64 on the treble side. This one's out by a 1/64, which means I gotta take a 1/32 off the saddle, and I do believe we got enough there to do that. So that'll be what I'll do to this guitar to correct the improper string action. Something that I see a lot is improper nut action. The distance between the string and the first fret. I like to go 1, 2, 3 frets down, fret that, and then measure that distance. Unfretted, there should be about 20 thou there. Let's just see if I can grab that feeler gauge. That's 12. This is 20 thou here. And it's a little on the high side. Seems fine on the treble side, but a little high on the bass side. And we're going to correct that. Provided we got the right gauge of strings on it. So if we've got a big fat string here, you can see how it's sitting in there. That's a little too deep for me. It should be up and out a little bit. This one's sitting up really high and proud out of the nut. And I'm going to have to go through and measure each one of these, and we're going to get it playing really nice. But that's another common problem, is the nut action at the first fret is incorrect. We hate that. We hate that. We hate that. Another big issue is loose bracing inside the guitar. This all develops over time. They might not necessarily manifest themselves as rattles, but everything is moving inside here. This is why it's lifting up at the back, and this is why it's getting sucked in at the top. There's not much you can do. Like I said, even the most expensive guitars will have a certain amount of deflection that way. And that's it. You got to live with it and hopefully be able to have enough bridge saddle to get the action back where it should be, and then the guitar settles down over time. We're done with it. We can kind of just, you know, figure out why Taylor has made their necks come off so this can all be adjusted. This is to compensate for the problem that's going to happen even to their unbelievably expensive guitars. That's what I know today.
Let's carry on a little bit farther.
Humidity is a big issue. If your guitar dries up, it's going to twist up, it's going to blow away, and it ain't going to be any fun. So that's another big issue with your acoustic guitar. If you want it to last over 30 years, decent humidity in your house, guitar sound hole humidifiers, all that great kind of stuff, it all helps. And it all makes a difference. And we'll have to thank my friend Gary for volunteering his guitar for this little video. And what I'm going to do is fix this thing up, and hopefully it's going to go for a good long time. Like I said, I don't see guitars like this very often that have they've stood the test of time. Anyhow, cheers, folks. And don't forget, oh, my sticker's covered up there with bottles of stuff and batteries and things. Don't forget, if you don't have a sticker, send me a message and I'll get you the info to get a sticker. Now, it's weird to send a personal message. I'm going to go through this just because it took me like a long time to figure it out with YouTube's new format. So to send me a personal message, you have to go to my channel, the channel page, and then there's a thing that says about, and when you click about, in that box that appears, there will be a thing that says send a message. Imagine that. Anyway, till next time, folks, cheers. Thanks for all the support. Keep rocking, keep playing, and I'll keep fixing them. Bye for now. One more thing I just wanted to add that I may not have said. How important it is to stick with the string gauge that the guitar was built around. If you start jerking around with the string gauges that the guitar didn't come with, you're going to have trouble. I see it a lot. So, you know, check out the manufacturer specs. Don't put really light strings on your acoustic guitars. They just hate it. And that's all. Cheers.